Intention beads, believe and achieve. Link in the description below. Hello, fabulous superstar Aquarius. Welcome to your horoscope for the month of September 2020, looking at life and love. I am your astrologer, Nadiya Shah. Thank you for being here. It is a remarkable astrological month. It is a very active sky now. And for you, a big theme for this month, at least where it comes to the important lunar events taking place, it comes down to finances on the one hand, resources, wealth, and understanding value. There's also a deeply transformative energy with you now in all kinds of ways, and this may be a month where big changes are afoot. So let's start with the full moon that is taking place right around the second of the month. This full moon is happening in a part of the sky for you that has to do with money you earn and money that you spend. It is also connected to self-esteem and self-worth. Now, there is a beautiful alignment taking place between this full moon and Uranus. Uranus, of course, being your modern ruling planet. And this suggests that what is happening with you in terms of self-esteem, what is happening with you in terms of your finances, it is deeply meaningful to you personally, that you are that much more invested in it. And this beautiful alignment ultimately tells me that things are changing in a way that is benefiting you, in a way that is surprising you, and in a way that very likely you will love very much. These are quick and high changes at that. So for some, this might be a time when you find that there is opportunity to create more prosperity for yourself, and that feels like quite a boost now. It could be an incredible opportunity or an idea that you're able to translate into an opportunity. If it is that you work from home or with homes, especially with Uranus moving through the foundation of your chart, well, it will very well be that that makes the prosperity that much more likely. And it may be at this time that you feel there's some type of fortunate turn where it comes to a client or a customer that benefits you. Now, this may also be one of those moments where you get to understand something more deeply, rooted in a sense of self that shifts your understanding of healthy self-love, of healthy self-esteem. Now, that may actually end up being one of the more valuable things that can occur right about now. And if it is that you are looking to spend in some way, well, I do think that expenditures now actually could benefit you in all kinds of ways. Of course, you want to be smart about it. You want to make sure you're coming from a place of prosperity. But if there ever was a sky that said you could get a really good deal, this really would be it. Now, as we navigate later in the month, it is going to be the 17th that we are going to have a new moon. Now, this new moon is going to take place in a part of the sky that has to do with your relationship to financial institutions. And it has to do with larger sums of money. So things like commissions, grants, loans, bursaries, benefits you qualify for, all of that is covered here. But it also speaks to wealth more generally, the wealth that you have, how you define your wealth. It speaks to your understanding of emotional and spiritual wealth and prosperity. This part of the sky also connects to profound and meaningful transformation and regeneration. Now, the really great news is there are beautiful alignments playing out between this new moon and Saturn and Pluto. That is all about the power move that benefits you, that helps you to transform your circumstances in a way that lasts well after this month is over, perhaps even well after this year is over. This is a very prosperous energy. And so if it is that you were hoping to renegotiate terms on a loan or on a mortgage, or if it is that you were looking into any kind of commission payments that you've been waiting on, or even just a grant, benefits, all of that, very blessed at this time. What does transpire is designed to set you up in beautiful ways for a very long time to come. Now, I would also add, because this is about profound and meaningful transformation, if you ever needed a sign that you are different, where it felt as if you really were now transformed from the inside out, this energy can help you in that regard. If it is that you are engaged in a process of transformation, like a psychological process or perhaps physical rehabilitation, tremendous gains and a real sense of difference can be felt at this time. Now, where it comes to matters of love, the really big news is that right around the 6th of the month, it is going to be Venus that changes signs, moving into your opposite sign, and will be here in your opposite sign right into the first days of next month. So you've got lots of time to benefit from these vibrations. But keep in mind, right smack dab in the middle of the month, Venus will be speaking with your modern ruling planet Uranus in a conversation of tension. That is a more difficult energy. That, on the surface of it, is a romantic surprise that does not go how you anticipated, that really may not work at all. And so keep that in mind. But this can also be some sense of being more honest with yourself, perhaps being surprised by the level of honesty that ultimately helps you to understand where you are in love and why. So for those of you open to meeting someone new, the overall energy here is that love is a beautiful thing, that you feel that you are connecting with people who have real long-term potential. Of course, we do have that bit of an erratic moment right in the middle of the month, so you do want to be careful with that. But outside of that, it may feel as if it's that much more easy to meet others. For those of you who are just starting to date somebody, normally Venus moving into your opposite sign can indicate a sense that you are moving towards a more stable or longer term future with this person, that you can envision yourself actually being with this person. The only thing you really want to be mindful of course, is what's happening smack dab in the middle of the month with that Uranian connection, because that is where this person may behave in a way that helps you to see them very differently than you did before. By the time we get to that new moon, you are looking into the truth more deeply about yourself and about this person. And that energy, along with that Uranian energy, it speaks to an all or nothing kind of time, a make or break moment, if you will, that helps you to understand whether or not you want to move forward with them. And for those of you who are in an established bond, this month and with Venus in your opposite sign, well, that tends to be really nice. It makes your partner that much easier to get along with, that much sweeter, which can be very beautiful. But of course, in the middle of the month, we've got that erratic energy. So remember, romantic surprises are not received the way intended. And so keep that in mind. But for all that, we also have that very powerful new moon, which is about conscious changes and consciously deciding where it is that you are ready to close a particular chapter. And if it is that you are in a relationship that may not be the right relationship for you, this is where it starts to feel like you really are ready to walk a brand new path. But if it is that your relationship is strong, well, that new moon will ensure that the bond is that much stronger. What I love about this month for you, well, look, there is a lot here. And in addition to all of this very important energy, we've got big moves happening in the sky. On the 9th of September, Mars is going to go retrograde. Now, I will link to the Mars retrograde special horoscope in the description below. But that is going to be a very important moment for you. Keep in mind, conversations just open your mind, help you to see the truth. They may frustrate you, they may anger you, but there is truth behind the intensity of emotion that you may feel. And it is going to be in the middle of the month that Jupiter goes direct, late in the month Saturn goes direct, all in the sign just before yours. I see this as a month of karmic cleansing, karmic closure. And this is the beginning of setting the stage for that very powerful celestial event set to take place at the end of the year. Once we navigate into December, Jupiter and Saturn moving into your sign are going to meet, in an extremely fortunate celestial event, and that truly is a brand new chapter that has the potential to put your life in a whole other place. But right now, as these planets change directions and start moving forward, it is the beginning of setting that stage to your powerful new beginning. Well, thank you so much for watching. You can get a video like this every week by logging on to nadiyashah.com. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Superstars get expanded, exclusive videoscopes each and every week, unlimited access to special horoscopes and more. All of this in the superstar space. I look forward to meeting you there. It'll be a great month. Enjoy.